In this video, I am going to be discussing whether or not it's worth it for California homeowners to go solar in 2022. Hi, my name is Jaime Greene, the Solar Queen, and I help homeowners make the switch from dirty energy from the utility company over to clean, renewable energy from the sun that they own. So it's a big leap when you go from traditional ways of getting your power to clean, renewable energy. And the truth is you're gonna save so much money when you go solar, especially if you know you're gonna live in your home long-term. So California is the leading state per capita when it comes to rooftop solar for residential solar installations. We're hopefully going to continue leading the charge and setting the example for the rest of the United States of America when it comes to solar adoption and net energy metering laws that hopefully stay put. We are hearing some rumblings from the California Public Utility Commissioner about some possible changes when it comes to net energy metering. And I will go over that in a different video, but it's something to be aware of, that the changes could take place. So right now we're under NEM 2.0, and that moves homeowners over to time of use. It grandfathers them in for a 20-year net energy metering agreement with the utility company. It allows them to export excess energy into the grid and receive a net energy metering credit. And most homeowners pay $10 a month for their connection fee, is what we call it in the industry. But right now, the utility companies, the main ones, Pacific Gas and Electric, Southern California Edison, and San Diego Gas and Electric, they're pushing the CPUC, or the California Public Utility Commissioner, to make changes and adopt NEM 3.0. NEM 3.0 is, you can go back to this video and you can watch what I'm talking about when it comes to the impending NEM 3.0 changes, and it's not favorable for homeowners. I am going to actually be going to San Francisco on January 13th to protest. I'm not a protester, but I want to stand up for California homeowners because I believe in solar power so firmly and the adoption for solar energy in our state, that I want to preserve what's already in place for homeowners who want to go solar in the future, who have yet to go solar. So this is it's not necessarily a protest, but it's us standing up for the industry, for jobs that the solar industry creates. There's so many things that go into putting a solar system on your rooftop, more than just meeting with me per se. So it's really, really important. You can go to savecaliforniasolar.org and sign the petition. The CPUC is going to be making their decision, or announcing their decision, on, I believe, January 27th, 28th. So we really need to get signatures in and get it onto the governor's desk to put a halt to NEM 3.0. Trust me when I say it is not favorable for any of the homeowners, any of the residents in California. So Californians have experienced wildfires. We have experienced extreme drought. We have experienced higher temperatures, climate change, global warming. We are all feeling the effects of it. Whether you believe that or not, the world is changing. The climate is changing. And we, as homeowners and business owners, we can do something about that. And making a statement of going solar, not only is gonna help your bank statements keep more money in your banks, it's going to make a statement to the world that, hey, I'm doing my part to help our planet slow down, reduce the need for carbon, for coal, for our energy, and go with renewable energy that comes from the sun with the help of solar panels. So solar energy is also known as photovoltaic energy, or PV energy. There are all different kinds of solar panels on the market. Every solar installer that I know of and work with are gonna use the top tier, high quality solar panels. I will probably do a video on all the different solar panel manufacturers another day, but for the purposes of this video, I want to just talk about whether or not it's worth it to go solar in 2022, and if you live in California, does it make sense? It does make sense. Financially, it makes sense. Knowing the numbers I am putting out every day in my solar proposals to homeowners that are consulting with me and talking about making that switch to solar, it is an absolute savings for homeowners and business owners who I also help go solar, save on their energy costs. So your energy consumption might not be changing, but your utility bills are, because rates continue to increase. I just checked my utility bill today to see where my true up was at, and we don't have a true up because our solar system is working for us the way it is intended to, given how much energy we use on a daily basis and an annual basis. But I did notice that the peak hour kilowatt hour rates and peak hours are from 4 to 9. They're about 33 cents a kilowatt hour, and non-peak is 30 cents a kilowatt hour. When we went solar, our base rate when we were on the tiered system was like 17 cents a kilowatt hour. So it has nearly doubled. Our rates have nearly doubled in the last 3 years. It's insane. So the utility companies are continuing to raise the rates. They're going to be moving everyone over to time of use eventually. Even if you don't go solar, they're going to switch you over because they're trying to find ways to increase their revenues. They are still paying off lawsuits from all the fires from, you know, the years past. They're probably still paying off the San Bruno lawsuits that happened, gosh, 11, 12 years ago, when there was that gas explosion and where lives were lost down in San Bruno because of the gas explosion in that neighborhood. So PG&E is in a lot of legal trouble, and they have a lot of lawsuits to pay off. So they are, of course, passing those costs over through to the homeowners and business owners that are paying for their electricity. But there's another way to do it, and that's with solar energy, and that's where you get solar panels installed on your rooftop. The solar panels and all of the equipment that is necessary to go solar gets wrapped up. You can either pay for your solar with cash, or you can finance it. There's a couple of different ways that you can get solar. Those are the two ways I recommend people get solar, is to either pay cash or finance it, but you can lease it, you can sign a power purchase agreement. There's several ways to get solar. Regardless of which way you do it, you're gonna save money. You're gonna always be ahead of in the savings when it comes to paying traditionally for your electricity. So is it worth it for Californians to go solar in 2022? Yes, it is. I'm going to save you, solar is gonna save you anywhere from 20, 30, 40, sometimes 60 and 70%. It all depends on how much energy you use, how you're being billed for your energy by the utility companies. Are you a high usage energy user, or are you really conservative as it is? If you're on the conservative side, your energy savings are gonna be much less than the big, big consumers of energy, because the utility companies penalize people who use a lot of energy from the grid. They penalize them in their billing. So the other thing that is gonna help most homeowners is the federal tax credit. And I'm gonna do another video on how the federal tax credit works in probably my next video. But the tax credit is currently 26% of the total cost to go solar. There has been some extensions. Like last year, we thought it was gonna reduce down to 22% when 2021 was coming to an end, but there was a bill that got passed, and it extended out the tax credit to be 26% until the end of 2022, and then reduced down from there. The bill that just got shut down, the build Back Better bill. We were really hoping that that was going to help the renewable energy industry and the solar industry, in that the tax credit may have gone up to 30% instead, be extended for another 10 years and actually not be a tax credit, but more of a tax rebate that would allow all homeowners that go with solar to get a 30% tax rebate, which is more favorable for more homeowners, because not everybody has the tax liability that you do need to have to be able to claim the tax credit. So I'll do a video on that next, and just keep in mind, I am not a certified public accountant. I am not a tax advisor, but I can at least speak to how the tax credit works, and also advise you to speak to your tax consultant about whether or not you qualify for the tax credit or not. But Californians who do have tax liability and can take advantage of the tax credit will have 26% of the cost of their solar system or going solar. Like, I had a homeowner today, we were going through their scope of work, and it came up that they need a main service panel upgrade, and it has to be relocated based on the location of the gas meter next to and above the main service panel. So the service panel isn't rated high enough to take in the back feed of the solar system, because every single bus bar is like loaded up. So there's no space for the solar system, which that's a whole nother video. But the point being is that if they include the main service panel in with their solar system, and it's all covered in a solar loan, and because they have to have it done to go solar, that cost is going to be included in the 26% federal tax credit that they can take advantage of. So it's so worth it to get solar for homeowners here in California in 2022. I would highly, highly, highly encourage you to go solar sooner than later in 2022. So start thinking of it now rather than summertime, because by the time you think about it in the summertime, solar installers across the country, across the state, are going to be so overwhelmed with so many homeowners that are pushing to get solar before the ITC reduces down to 22%. And the other thing is we've been seeing supply chain shortages with solar panels, with solar inverters, with main service panel equipment, all the things that are needed for solar, we're seeing shortages. So you want to take advantage, you want to make a decision as quickly as possible to get solar so that you can get in the queue to go solar. I've seen main service panels take several months to get done by the utility company, and things come up, weather, storms, down powered lines, it's the utility companies have a huge say in it. The solar installers, they're gonna put you in it, like try and get you in queue and get it done fast enough, but really it comes back down to the utility companies to make that happen and get it scheduled and lined up. And so being that California, so many homeowners are going solar, you wanna make the decision earlier, get everything submitted and signed and done, preferably first quarter, so that you can get installed. And if you need a main service panel, hopefully everything gets done and turned on in time for you to take advantage of all of the free energy during the summertime, when that is the time when most of your solar power is going to be generated for the entire year, like the wintertime months, when there's no more sun today. And it's, what time is it? It's 5 o'clock, the sun's gone down, and it's been raining all day long. So we're pulling from the grid right now, but we are debiting from our net energy metering credits that we have been storing up throughout the year. So I think that, you know, if you're a homeowner in California and you're on the fence and you're questioning it, or you don't know who to talk to, I want you to reach out to me. In the description below, you can connect with me on all the different social medias, but you can certainly go to my website, www.jaimegreenthesolarqueen.com, and you can fill out a questionnaire there. We can set up a time to meet over getting you solar powered for either your home or your business, because I help both. go solar, and save on your energy costs. You're gonna see your ROI. Businesses are gonna see it faster than homeowners just because they can take advantage of macro's depreciation. But the residential homeowners, they'll get to be able to take advantage of the tax credit. That's 26% until the end of 2022. And you're gonna wanna lock in the NEM 2.0, because if the CPUC does go ahead and pass NEM 3.0, it's not gonna be as favorable for homeowners to go solar, because your connection fees are gonna be increasing. You're gonna go to net billing instead of net metering, which is what we have in place now. There's a way to get around the net billing, but you're just gonna have to get a much, much bigger solar system to be able to offset the summertime usage, when most homeowners use the most energy in their summertime. So I hope that this video was really helpful. Make sure if you liked this video, give it a thumbs up. Share it out to your neighbors and friends and family that are thinking of going solar. Subscribe to the channel so that you're updated on more solar videos and information that I share on this channel specifically. And I really want to help you go solar and save on your energy costs. I want you to own your power, you be in charge of it, and live a little bit more independent from the utility company with clean renewable energy, and live with sustainability as much as you possibly can, because we all can do our part in it. So I hope that this video is helpful, and I will see you all in the next video. Thanks so much.